Good morning, children. How are you all? Welcome to the last session of chapter number 5. Does it look the same? Let us revise what we did in our last session before proceeding further. You learnt about asymmetric shapes. Asymmetry means no symmetry. If a figure is divided into two unequal parts, then such figure is known as a symmetric shape or figure. You also learned a shape may be symmetric, but the color scheme of the shape can make it asymmetric. Mirror images. We'll start the session with what are mirror images. Earlier you learned what are mirror halves. Mirror halves means when a shape is divided along the line of symmetry, the two halves will look the same. Now let us see what are mirror images. Mirror image. Kids, when you look yourself in a mirror, what do you see? Yes, you see yourself there. Exactly the same, except reversed. In such an image, the right side of you appears on the left side and vice versa. Let us see few examples of how a mirror image of an object will look. Here the left side pictures are all the original pictures and the right side gives me the mirror image. In the first, instead of a triangle, mirror image gives me a picture in a square. Second, it is in semicircle, but the mirror image gives me a shape in circle. Third one, instead of one sparrow, the mirror image gives me a pair of sparrows. This is how the mirror images look. Mirror games. Let us do an activity here using a piece of mirror. Here is a picture of a dog. You can place a mirror on the dotted line. Then the part of the dog to the right side of the line will be hidden behind the mirror. What will you see is like the picture shown in A. You can see a dog here and a line drawn here. You need to keep a mirror here. Let me keep a mirror here now. See, I have kept a mirror here. Can you see the reflection? Yes. How does it look like now? This picture exactly matches the picture given on your right side. So this is called mirror image. Let us do the other questions now. B, you can see two figures here. We should keep a mirror either vertically or horizontally in this image to get this mirror image. As I can see two heads here, I'm going to keep my mirror first vertically. Let me keep the mirror vertically and see. Now, can you see the mirror image now? If you match this with the figure given on your right side, it will be exactly same. So, the mirror is to be kept like this to get a mirror image given in the book on the right side. C. This is the picture and this is the mirror image we have to get. I can see a head here. Here you can see two heads on the opposite sides. So if I keep my mirror vertically, I can get this image. Let us see if I get it that way. Can you see the mirror image now? Is it same as given here? One diamond at the top, one diamond at the bottom, and two heads. Question number D. You need to keep a mirror in this shape to get a mirror image like this. Here you can just see two heads. So if I keep my mirror just on the head portion, I should get this image. So I'm going to keep the mirror like this. Can you see the mirror image now clearly? Only the head portion. So this is the way you will keep the mirror in this question. Let's now come to E part. Here you need to get this reflection from this picture. You need to have two heads. So I'm going to keep my mirror horizontally so that I can get a reflection of the head in my mirror. Can you see two heads now, and the tail portion also, two tails on both sides? Can you see the reflection now? So this is how you will keep the mirror to get this reflection or this mirror image. Half a turn. Once there was a king. He was upset because thieves kept stealing costly jewels from his locker. You can see his locker here. The locker could be opened by giving its handle half a turn. Another half turn and the locker would be locked. King would often leave the locker open thinking it was locked. Can you give me the reason? Half a turn means you can see a red dotted line I have drawn here in a semicircle. That is from top yellow portion to the bottom yellow portion is half a turn. You can see two lockers here, open and locked one, and both looks the same. So the king never came to know when his locker was open and when it was locked. So one day the king's clever daughter asked the king to put a dot on one of the yellow blades. So the king put a dot on the top of the yellow blade when the locker was open. So when he closed the locker by turning it into half a turn, the black dot came down. So this helped him to find out when his locker was open and when his locker was closed. The king had many more lockers like these. Check on giving them half a turn. Here I have tried to give some options, like putting a dot in the top in the first figure, giving a dash for the second, block of black in the third, and vertical line in the fourth locker. You can all think of more options and do it in your own way. Here you can see half turn and quarter turn. Two half turns will make one full turn, and four quarter turns will make one full turn. Page 78. Same after half turn. Guess which of the shapes below would look the same after half a turn. Let us see now which all shape are same after half a turn. I have made a clock here. 12, 6, 3 and 9. When a shape moves from 12 to 6, it takes a half turn. The first shape is square. Let us keep the square like this. I have marked a point here. So when this point comes to 6 means half turn. Has the shape changed? No. So square does not change after half turn. Now rectangle. Again, I'm keeping like this. You can see the line here. It is at 12. Now I'm going to bring this line to 6. This is half turn. Has the shape changed? No. It is same. The next is circle. You can see the point here, a 12, half turn. Has the shape changed? No, it is same as before. Then elongated rectangle. Elongated means this way. See the point here now, it is a 12. After the turn, that is half turn, it will be like this. Can you see the change in shape? No, it is same as before. The next is triangle. Can you see the point now at 12? Half turn. Now the point has come to 6. Has the shape changed? Yes. The pointed part of the triangle has come down and the broader base has gone up. So the triangle changes its shape after half turn. Next, hexagon. You can see the point here. Now I'm going to make it like this, that is half turn. Has the shape changed? No, it is same as before. Finally, pentagon. Can you see now the point at 12? After half turn, it will be like this. This has come down. Again, like triangle, pentagon also does not look same after half turn. The pointed tip has come down and the broader base has gone up. So we can say, except pentagon and triangle, all other shapes look same after half turn. Did you all follow, children? Children, have you seen a windmill? I'm sure you must have all seen a windmill. Here I have shown you a windmill. In your maths textbook, page number 80, it teaches you how to make a paper windmill. It is an interesting activity. You can all try it. As we are doing turns now, that is half turn, quarter turn, etc. The turns can be either clockwise direction or anti-clockwise direction. Clockwise direction means moving in the same direction as the hands of the clock. Anti-clockwise direction is moving in the opposite direction. So now tell me whether it will look the same on quarter of a turn and half a turn. Let us see. You can see a windmill in the original position. Let us take quarter of a turn. The second windmill shows quarter turn. Does it look the same? Yes, it looks the same. Now let us take half a turn. That is from top to bottom. The third figure shows the half turn. Does it look the same? Again, yes, it looks the same. So we can say quarter turn and half turn of a windmill will look the same. 1/4 turn. Now you know what is 1/4 or quarter turn. Here, a picture of a fan having all four blades in blue color is shown to you. The second picture is after 1/4 turn. Does the fan look the same after 1/4 turn? Yes. Now come to the second figure, having two blades in blue color and two blades in orange color. When the fan takes quarter turn, does it look the same? No, it does not look the same because the color of the wing changes. 1/3 turn. Which fan will look same on a 1/3 turn? Here you can see two fans, A and B. A has all three blades in purple color. Fan B has two purple colored blades and one green colored blade. Now, after the turn, you can see the picture below. fan A, after the turn, it looks same as above. But if you see fan B, it does not look same because of the change in color in the blade of the fan. 1/6 turn. You all know a hexagon has 6 sides. So from one tip of the side of the hexagon to the other tip of the side of the hexagon will give you 1/6 turn. Any shape having 6 tips will look the same on 1/6 turns. You can see 3 examples given here. In this chapter, you learn to identify the symmetrical, that is mirror halves images, and non-symmetrical, that is asymmetrical shapes, figures and English alphabets. You learned what are mirror images. Finally, you learned the clockwise and anti-clockwise, half turn, 1/3 turn, quarter turn and 1/6 turn. Children, we have come to the end of this chapter. Learn what all was taught to you in these 3 sessions. Try to do all the practice time questions on your own. Revise thoroughly. Take care and bye.